We are discussing about the French Revolution. So by now we have seen that what all happened, what were the events and situation, and those led to the revolution or revolution type environment. So France finally abolishes monarchy and becomes a republic. The situation which we talked about continued to be tense during the following years, means the later years, because many things happened. There was a constitution being made by National Assembly, and that constitution was holding, means the monarchy was there, but it was called as the constitution with monarchy, with three different levels of you can say different legislative and judiciary like this, and there were different citizens, means active and passive citizens. Although this Louis 16, he has signed the constitution, but he was talking to King of Prussia. That is, he entered into secret negotiations with them. And the neighboring countries also, they were worried about the development which was taking place in France. So they planned to invade, send troops. But before this can happen, the National Assembly voted in April 1792 to declare war against Prussia and Austria both. And thousands of volunteers thronged from the provinces to join the army. And they saw it in a different way. They saw that they are doing it against the kings and atrocities or aristocracies all over Europe. So among the patriotic song they sang was the Marseillaise, composed by poet Roger de Lay. And it was sung for the first time by volunteers from Marseille as they marched into Paris. So got this name. So the Marseillaise is now the national anthem of France. So this is how this France got its national anthem from this story. Now the revolutionary wars, any war will bring loss and economic difficulty. So this war also did that, because the revolutionary war culminated happened to do what a war does. Men were fighting, so women were in home, they were looking after the family, and if you see that the constitution of 1791 gave political rights only to the richer section. Only to the richer section. So their political clubs become an important rallying point for people who wish to discuss government policies, and they would need to form their plan, because they want this revolution, that is larger section of population, they were convinced that the revolution had to be carried further. It cannot be stopped. So there were certain clubs, and most importantly, the successful club was Jacobins, which got its names from the former convent of Saint Jacob in Paris. That is why Jacobins. Women also took part, and we'll talk about that later. So the member of the Jacobin club, this belong mainly to the less prosperous section of the society, which include shopkeepers, artisans like the shoemakers, pastry cooks, watchmakers, printers, the servants and daily wage workers. And their leader was Maximilian Robespierre. So a large group among the Jacobins, they decided to start wearing long striped trousers similar to those worn by dock workers, like this. So this was why? This was to set themselves apart from the fashionable section of society, especially nobles who wore knee breeches, means up to knee. So they started wearing the full pants, you can say. There's a word came which was convent. So building belonging to a community devoted to a religious life. So why they started wearing that? It was just a way, or you can say symbol, to proclaim the end of the war wielded by the wearers of knee breeches. And these Jacobins, they were known as sans-culottes. Sans-culottes, which means those without knee breeches, wearing whole. So this was sans culottes mean, or the men, for men, this means that they wore in addition to red cap. That means they were wearing red cap that symbolizes liberty. But women were not allowed to do so. This is a famous painting. This is this rare painting of a woman artist. And this is revolutionary events that made it possible for women to train with established painters and to exhibit their work in the salon, which was an exhibition held every 2 years. So this painting is indicating female allegory of liberty. That is, the female form symbolizes the idea of freedom. So in summer 1792, the Jacobins planned an insurrection of a large number of these Parisians who were angered by the short supplies of and high prices of the basic food. On the morning of August 10, they stormed the palace of the Tuileries, massacred the king guards and held the king himself as hostage for several hours. And then later, they imprisoned the assembly voted to imprison the royal family. Elections were held, and now on all the men who are 21 plus, regardless of wealth, they can vote. So the newly elected assembly was called convention now. On 21st September 1792, it abolished the monarchy, and now the France is declared as a republic. Republic is what? It is the type of government where the people elect the government, including the head of the government also. There is no place for the monarchy. Okay. Louis XVI was sentenced to death by court on the charge of treason. Treason is what? It is the betrayal of one's country or government. And later, her wife also met the same fate. On 21st January 1793, Louis XVI was executed publicly at the Palace de la Concorde. But there was a reign of terror. That is a point or a duration from 1793 to 1794. This was referred to as reign of terror. Atanka samay. Robespierre, he followed a very strong policy of very severe policy of control and punishment. All those whom he saw as enemies, like the enemies of the Republic, like ex-nobles, clergy, member of the political parties, even members of his own party, who would not agree with him, they were arrested, imprisoned, and then tried by the revolutionary tribunal. It is, if the court found them guilty, they will be guillotined. Guillotined, this is guillotined. The guillotine actually is a device consisting of two poles and a blade with which a person is beheaded. It was named after Dr. Guillotine, who made it. So this is of this form, these are two poles. Here we have a place to put head of the person who is going to be beheaded. And here we have a very sharp knife, very heavy, you can say blade, not knife, blade. So just it is left to come down with full force, and the person who is here, he will be beheaded. So Dr. Guillotine invented it. So Robespierre government, it issued law placing a maximum ceiling on wages and prices. Meat and bread were rationed. Peasants were forced to transport their gold grains to the cities and sell it at the fixed price by the government. The price which are fixed by the government. And the use of expensive white flour was forbidden. All the citizens were required to eat the pain, that is equally bread. That is, you know, that is the, this is the French name, so we can call it as bread. A loaf made of whole meat, whole wheat. So equality was also sought to be published in speech also in address. So calling, rather than calling traditional monsieur like sir and madame as madam, the Frenchmen and women are henceforth citoyen and citoyenne, like female and male citizen. Churches were shut down or either they are converted into barracks or offices. Now Robespierre, he pursued his policy so relentlessly that even his supporters, they were angry. They began to demand moderation. Finally, he was convicted by the court in July 1794, and he also was guillotined. Apart from this, you know, the government would use to, you can say, entice people staging of festival. This is a picture of that. So a directory or directory rules France. Now, the Jacobin government, it fell. So, the fall of Jacobin government allowed the wealthier middle class to seize power now. The new constitution was introduced, which denied the vote to these proprietated sections of society. So, it provided for two elected legislative councils. They appointed a directory and execution made up of 5 members. Why? Because they wanted to safeguard against the concentration of power in a one-man executive as under the Jacobins government. The director often clashed with the legislative councils who sought to dismiss them. So it was very unstable regime. That is, the political instability of the directory paved the way of the rise of military dictator Napoleon Bonaparte. All these changes in the form of government, the ideals of freedom, the equality of before the law and the fraternity remained inspiring ideas and motivation not only for the France or French people, but Europe during the following century and for most of the world. Now, what happened to women? Did women have a revolution? Here is a picture that shows all. This is a pictorial representation of an event when women marched to Versailles and brought the king back with them to Paris. From the beginning, very beginning, women were involved. You know, they were participating in the events, all the events of the important changes in French society. And they hope that when they will have a revolution, the government will make certain policies and measures to improve their lives. And most of the women of the third state, they had to work for a living. They worked as, say, seamstresses, laundresses, sold flowers, and they used to, you know, go to free or sell fruit and vegetable at the market, were employed as domestic servants, as domestic maid and servants in the houses of prosperous people. Most women did not have any access to education or job training. Only the daughters of nobles, they were given the study, and even after that, they got married, or they were forced to be married. So working women had also to care for their families. That is, they have to cook, fetch water, queue up for bread, and they also have to look for the children. And their wages were also less. So these all things, in order to discuss and voice these interests, women started their own political clubs and newspapers. About 60 women clubs came up in different French cities. The Society of Revolutionary and Republican Women was one of the most famous of them. And one of their main demands was what? Was simply that the women enjoy the same political rights as the men are enjoying. So women were actually disappointed that the constitution of 1791 reduced them to passive citizens. That is, the citizens who are not allowed to vote. So they demanded to vote, to be elected to the assembly, to hold a political office. Women wanted that. Only then they would feel, or they felt, would their interest be represented in the new government. So in the early years, revolutionary government did introduce laws in order to improve the lives of women, and they created state schools. Schooling was made compulsory for all girls. Their fathers could not force them to marry against their will, and once the marriage is done, the marriage has to be registered, and divorce is also made legal. Now women can be trained for jobs, could become artists, and they can also run small businesses. But women's struggle for these equal political rights, it continued. And during the reign of terror, the new government issued laws of ordering, closure of women club, banning of political activities, and many were arrested and executed. One of them is this woman, Olympe de Gouges. So women movement for voting right and equal wages continued throughout the, various part of the world next 200 years. So the fight for the vote was carried out through international suffrage movement during the late 19th and early 20th century. So the example of this political activities of French women during the revolutionary years was kept alive as this memory, because people actually followed that. So it was finally in 1946, French women got the right to vote. So this is a picture just showing that how women are queuing up in a bakery just in order to get some bread or food. Then came the abolition of slavery, one of the most revolutionary social reform of the Jacobean regime was abolition of slavery. See, the colonies in the Caribbean, that is the Martinique and Guadeloupe and San Domingo, they were important suppliers of commodities, very basic commodities like tobacco, indigo and sugar and coffee. But Europeans, they don't want to go in the foreign land. So how to get this labor? This was met by triangular slave trade between Europe, Africa and Americas. Europe, Africa and America. What happened? The slave trade began in the 17th century. French merchants sailed from the port of Bordeaux and Nantes to African coast, where they bought slaves from the local chieftains. Branded and shackled, these slaves, they are packed tightly into the ships for 3 month long voyage across the Atlantic to the Caribbean. There they were sold to plantation owners. The exploitation of the slave labor made it possible to meet the growing demand in the European market for sugar, coffee, indigo. You see, these Bordeaux and Nantes, the port cities, they because of this, they were economically prosper because of the flourishing slave trade. So this is just an emancipation of slaves. Here you see, this is there are two things written: the rights of a man, and then we have the inscription below, which is the freedom of the unfree. A French woman is preparing to civilize the African American Indians slaves by giving them European clothes. These are the European clothes. They wanted them to become like them and to be, you can say, become civilized like them. So throughout this 19th century, no criticism or less criticism was there for this slavery. The National Assembly held long debates for the rights of man and for the colonies, their colonies also, but they did not pass any law fearing opposition from the businessmen who are actually into the slave trade. So it was finally the convention which in 1794 legislated to free all slaves in the French overseas possessions, but it was turned down shortly for short. It was very for short term measure. 10 years later, Napoleon Bonaparte, he reintroduced the slavery. The plantation owner understood their freedom as including the right to enslave African Negroes. These who are Negroes? The term used for the indigenous people of Africa, or you can say south of Africa, African desert Sahara. It is derogatory term and we don't use it now. It is very derogatory. So these African Negroes, in pursuit of their economic interests, slavery was finally abolished in French colonies in 1848. So how this triangular thing was done? It was like this. Okay, just this is Europe. Now the from these two ports, people would go to Africa. Now they from the local chieftains, they purchase or buy these slaves, and then they go to the Caribbeans. So this is how you can say. This is a triangle. This is the, you can say, a triangular way of solving the issue of labor was done. Now here, what was the everyday life at that time? At that time, you see that various this after 1789 in France, there were certain changes in the lives of men and women and children. The revolutionary government took it upon themselves to pass law that would translate the ideas of liberty and equality. One important law that came into effect just after storming the Bastille in the summer of 1789 was the abolition of censorship. Previously, anything which is to be published or being printed, it has to go through the government, or government will have a look. But after that, it was being abolished. Abolition of censorship was done. So now with play, song, festive processions and books and everything, the people, or there were ability or allowance for people to do whatever they can. This is the picture of Napoleon Bonaparte. He is crossing the Alps. So in 1804, Napoleon Bonaparte crowned himself as the Emperor of France. Now he set out to conquer the neighboring European countries, dispossessing the dynasties and also creating kingdoms where he placed members of his family. Napoleon saw his role, or he was thinking that he is going to modernize the European countries, or Europe. He introduced many such laws like the protection of private property, uniform system of weights and measures provided by the decimal system. But initially people saw Napoleon as a liberator that would bring freedom for the people. But soon they understood that the Napoleon armies is actually an invading force. He actually lost in 1815 in Waterloo. He was defeated. And, you know, after a long time, then he was recognized that he was not actually the people man. The ideas of liberty and democratic right were the most important legacy of this French Revolution. That is why we are trying to learn it. These spread from France to rest of Europe during the 19th century, where these feudal system were eventually abolished. Colonies, people reworked the idea of freedom from bondage into the movement to create the sovereign national state. This happened in various places. In India also, Tipu Sultan, Ramon Roy, they were individuals who actually got influenced or responded to the ideas which were coming from revolutionary France. So this is how it happened. People, because of the regime, they got angry, they fought against them in order to get the basic rights that is available to everyone, and that has to be available to everyone from the birth. And they fought, and they finally got the way of life that they wanted to. And this spread, this actually sparked a new discussion, and that helped for the other countries or people. They got influenced, and these people finally took revolt, or even the government understood, and then they had a better life, not very good, but better life after that. Thank you so much.